In this tutorial, we're going to talk about the export options when exporting an OBJ or an STL file from Relief Maker. We have a relief here that we've created. If we look at the scene, we can see that it's comprised of a series of different models that we've positioned in a way that's pleasing to us. And now we want to go ahead and export this. So let's choose Export Relief. And whether or not we choose OBJ or STL, we're going to get the same set of results. So in our case, we'll choose OBJ, and we'll call this Mushroom. Let's press Save, and we'll see that we have three options. The easiest way to demonstrate what these are is to just show you each example. And so in the first case, we're going to generate a dense height field. Now let's quickly do the other two. We'll go Export Relief. We'll call this Mushrooms Decimated, and we'll choose Decimated Background. Let that go. And then finally, we'll choose Mushrooms Foreground. So now we're going to open these up in a program like Blender where we can look at the mesh and we'll try to determine what the differences are. So here we are inside of Blender, and we've opened up each of these options side by side. The one on the left is the dense height field, the one in the middle is the decimated background, and the one on the right is foreground only. Let's dive in and take a little bit of a closer look on the implications of each of these formats. If we click the dense height field, and we take a look at the mesh, and we zoom in, we can see that the mesh has incredible detail throughout the model, but also has detail equally on the flat areas. If we look at the decimated background model, we can see that the foreground, the actual content of the mushrooms, has that same level of high detail, but the background has a lot fewer triangles. Finally, if we take a look at foreground only and zoom in, we see that there is no background at all. Right? It cuts the mesh directly somewhat along the edges of the foreground model. So why would you choose one of these formats over the other? Well, the middle one with the decimated background is a substantially smaller file size. It doesn't have all of these little tiny triangles like you would find on the model itself, also replicated on the background. This actually saves a ton of data. And so unless you need that detail in the background, you probably shouldn't use it. So for most CNC applications or 3D printing applications, this is the one you're probably going to want to choose, the decimated background. Now, decimated background is not good for certain kinds of workflows. So if I wanted to go into here and then go into sculpt mode, I'm not going to have very good success in Blender, for example, or some other software, sculpting changes to this model here, right? So I'll try to add some detail here, but I'm not really getting any good quality like I would when I start sculpting on the area that is dense of the mesh, which is the foreground. So sculpting applications are the kinds of applications where you want the same number of triangles, this dense mesh, also on the background. If we compare that to the dense height field option, and I go into sculpt mode, we can see that the background mesh is dense enough for me to get good results. And it's the same density as on the model itself, right? So it really depends on the application that you're going for. Most of the time, unless you have a specific reason to choose dense height field, like you're going to be sculpting, or for whatever reason your downstream software needs the dense height field everywhere, usually decimated background is going to be what you want. If we look at the difference in file sizes, the fully dense mesh is 132 megs, whereas the decimated background mesh is only 48. This means that decimated backgrounds are so much smaller that they're easier to send, they're easier to back up, they're easier to import into your other software, they're easier and faster to create toolpaths because there's a lot less data it has to figure out. So unless you have a good reason, you should choose decimated. If you're going to go into a sculpting application or something that can handle very dense meshes, then choose the dense height field option. We're not really going to talk too much about foreground because you'll know whether or not you have applications that can consume this kind of data. and that's kind of beyond the scope of this video, but just be aware that that option exists, and this is what it looks like.